Objectively speaking, switchblades are pretty stupid. I was going to title this video Switchblades for Police and Security and then just talk about how they don't make a lot of sense from the perspective of what I do for a living, but the more I thought about it, the more I realized in my daily life there really isn't any reason to own a switchblade. When things like this exist, there isn't a reason to have something with an extra button. This is just a flipper-operated pocket knife. It's nothing astounding. It doesn't cost a lot of money. It's just a knife that opens when you push the flipper on the back, and it pretty much does it automatically with none of the legal restrictions of a switchblade. This isn't the best quality steel in the world. It's good, it's not the best. If you want a better quality steel, you can always get something else that does pretty much the same thing without the flipper assist, and you can get some of the best quality steel in the world, like this police model Spyderco here. The stack gear deals with the auto opening, the Spyderco, you can get a very high quality steel. And realistically, switchblades haven't made sense in an awfully long time, ever since the Spyderco Enduro and Delica line came out way back when I was a kid. Spyderco kind of killed off the whole idea of a switchblade being objectively reasonable. Butterfly knives, of course, have been out there for a while, and many, many years ago, switchblades and butterfly knives in many jurisdictions became an evil, evil thing that there's now legal restrictions against. As those restrictions are lifted still, we've come along in technology to the point where you don't need a switchblade. And realistically, the one thing a switchblade does well, work as a weapon, is kind of negated by the fact that out the front switchblades and the switchblade mechanisms in the side opening models are not as good as the locking mechanisms on modern pocket knives. Benchmade, CRKT, StatGear, Spyderco, all of them make very fast knives with thumb holes or thumb studs that allow you to open them up quickly and close them up quickly with one hand. If you're looking for something that operates as a weapon, there are much better options than switchblades. Not only these with stronger internal mechanisms that allow that blade to stay more securely locked, but there's also fixed blade options, which are just as concealable and just as quick to pull out as a switchblade and less likely to collapse up on your fingers. You can also get these as an added bonus with trainer versions of them that fit into the same sheath, so you can train what you're trying to use the knife for. There's lots of different versions of this type of thing out there on the market. And so I really don't think that, especially today, there's any reason to have a switchblade as a defensive weapon. Objectively, they just don't make any sense, which is why you don't see any of them in my stable here. You can get better steels, or at least equal quality steels, in other models. You can get knives that are as fast, you can get knives that are more practical, you can get knives that are far, far, far more tactical, so please don't tell my wife.
Hey, thanks for watching Free Field Training on YouTube, and while you're here, why don't you check out some of these other goofy videos that I've made, or you could subscribe, or maybe go over to Patreon and see how you get your name put on the videos, like these fine folks over here. All the links are, of course, down in the description. We'll see you guys next time.
You can get knives that are just as fast that are cheaper. You can get knives that are just as... You can get knives that are just as fast that are cheaper. You can get knives that are just as practical with just as good a steel. And you can get knives that are weapons that work a whole lot better and are less likely to pinch your fingers. So please, having said all that, don't tell my wife, because these things are so much fun!